Hi, today's video will be about a sore point. From time to time, I conduct interviews for our company and often encounter the curious thinking of candidates during code writing. And today, I will try to give the first fight to this trend. The first is because today, I will analyze only a small part of this issue, and I will try to develop the topic in future videos. If I am intrigued you, be sure to press the like button and let's go. To understand what I'm talking about, I suggest you code a little. I'm going to code a simple autocomplete component. The first step is, of course, to draw the input itself, store its state somewhere, and describe the onChange function. I think everything here is familiar and clear. Now, after changing the value in the input, you need to start loading the options into the autocomplete. Most often, I see the following code for such a task. Here, we've added another state to store options in autocomplete, and we've added useEffect, which will load the autocomplete options when you change the value in the input. The code is not complicated, so I won't explain it in more detail. I'll just add that the code doesn't take into account race condition and debounce logic and probably a lot of other things. None of this matters for the current video now. Maybe I'll make a separate video about it. In the meantime, let's get back to the topic of the episode and see what we got in the browser. Try to enter values into the input and immediately see the options suggested to us under it. Everything works. However, it is not yet possible to press on the option and to replace the value on clicked item in the input. Let's finish the code. We now have the onSelectSuggestion method, and in it we replace the value from the suggestion into the input and clear the suggestions. Everything seems to work perfectly. Let's go back to the browser. Enter the value again in the input and try to press on the first option in the autocomplete. The value was inserted into the input, but the list of options in the autocomplete did not disappear, but rather changed. Why did it happen? After all, we explicitly indicated that we wanted to clean up the list of suggested options, but it doesn't work. Let's go back to the code and see what went wrong. And so we cleaned up the suggestions list, but we also changed the value in the input. And as we know, when we change the value in the input, it fires useEffect. It means we send a new request to download suggestions again. Agree, it's an unpleasant bug, and in order to fix it, now you need to think about how to do it correctly. For example, you can create a Boolean flag called disableSuggestion and manage suggestion disabling for autocomplete. We will set it to true when we press on the autocomplete options and to false when we type in the input. And it works. But I have an impression that it is some kind of workaround, and the reason for it is useEffect. It reacts to absolutely any input change, but we really need to react to its changes in only single case when we type text in input. We've already identified the problem, and now I'll share the solution as I see it. And the solution lies in the phrase, clear instructions. Instead of changing one field, then useEffect will react to changes in this field and execute some other code, which may lead to changes in other components, and we don't know how long this chain can be. I suggest using clear short-end instructions described in a single function, and after the function execution, there won't be some non-obvious callbacks like useEffect. Enough theory, let's move on to practice. We've rolled back to the stage of writing the input again, and now let's try to add options for the autocomplete. Now the code looks a little different. As you can see, the differences from the previous code are very small. I don't use useEffect, but put the logic for loading options directly in the onChange method, and as a result, I have a small function that describes literally everything that should happen in the application as part of typing text in the input. This is what I call a clear instruction. And of course, we also need to handle the suggestion click. In the current implementation, it's very easy. We do everything the same as the previous time. Set a new value to the input and clear the suggestions. And this time it works. See for yourself. We can safely choose the movie Kill Bill. And after that, there are no side effects. That's why I like the clear instructions approach. Since this function states that there should be no suggestions, there are none, and there are no side effects, which can reduce the number of bugs in our application. And as you can now see, we use one less state variable, and everything still works. You may have found this topic ridiculous, but I have been interviewing candidates for my company for 1.5 years, and we have a coding step. And during 1.5 years, I honestly can't remember more than 2-3 candidates who hasn't used useEffect when working with input. Therefore, if it seems simple and obvious to you, ask your colleague how he writes such code, and it may surprise you. And of course, if you liked the video, be sure to press the like button and type a comment. I'm going to remove a couple of useEffect in my project. It is not difficult for you to type a comment, but I will be pleased. Bye.